Your mama know you ugly. You your daddy's son. Hey, we get turned up. 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 Big scary you. How do I watch this shit, man? I know I DVR'd it. Come on, bruh. Let me watch my DVR'd version, bruh. Come on, bruh. Oh no, they're doing it the wrong way, bruh. Don't do it that way, bruh. I'm trying to watch the DVR'd version. I gotta save it up, bruh. Oh, I'm doing the wrong, bruh. And here we go. Previously on The Walking Dead.
Previously on AMC's The Walking Dead.
Turn the lights up and...
stands with Negan and the Savior.
Gregory, you a bitch. Back. So Father Gabriel and Negan.
Hey. I might die. I very likely will die. I'm not asking to live. But you've given me redemption. And it's that which makes me no longer fear death. What I fear is a fruitless death.
Gregory. Bitch ass, Gregory.
Wakey, wakey, eggs, pancakey, Gregory.
Trevor, Stephen O, Simon.
No, thank you. No, yay. These cakes are made from scratch by yours truly. I use genuine hilltop sorghum. Nailed it myself.
You did?
There is a lot of love on this tray, Gregory, because I wanted to express love to you. Because you did the right thing. I told you if things start to feel hinky at the hilltop, come see me.
And I did, with zero hesitation.
Yeah. You went to the satellite outpost, as I instructed.
Which was incredibly impressive.
You told me that already.
I did.
Three times.
Bitch ass man.
Listen. You came to see me. And though I was already away dealing with that rank betrayal, which was unknown to you.
Indeed it was known. It was indeed unknown.
And you waited for me.
I wanted to tell you about Hilltop and Alexandria. Kingdom, but you were finding out at that point in Alexandria.
Gregory, you don't need to explain yourself over and over again. Hear me when I say I'm telling you, you did the right thing. Every step of the way.
Why did you bring me here?
I brought you here because we now stand on the precipice of greatness. You said you could solve the problem. Today's the day, Gregory. You fill your belly up with my love, and then you solve it.
Start by saying thank you for having me here today.
Eugene.
Negan, let me lay this down straight for you. I know how it is. Negotiating the slippery, steep terrain of managing resources and the population and the big, scary you. Which you might know. It's called the unknown. Listen, I mean it when I say it. Negan, I don't like killing people any more than you do.
I like killing people.
Oh, well, I think about killing the right people.
So you kill the right people at the right time. Everything falls into place. Everybody's happy. Well, some people more than others. But you kill one, and you could be saving hundreds more. And that is what we are all about. We save people.
That's why you're called the savior.
Play.
but the other communities will get the message and we achieve equilibrium. Plan A. Plan B.
People are a resource. Money on the table.
People are the foundation of what we are doing here! Face alive and making them dead in a very, very public and instructive way. We kill the right people in the wrongest way possible and we make them all watch.
That makes sense. I gotta do it overseas. Public crucifixion, Saudi Arabia.
Should we get our people out there? Line them up. Light him up?
No. I got some sort of hillbilly armor. We'd just be wasting metal on metal. And the RPG is stashed with the cash, so... Let's have ourselves a little chat. Simon, bring your new little friend. We may need him to say some words.
Gregory, you're on deck. Gary. Put 3 and 3 in the windows. Tell them to stay the hell down until we leave them. Well, shit. Sorry. Jesus Christ.
Any in a trailer. Oh shit, you're tripping.
I see Lee.
Machete. Father?
Yeah, I am. But he's gonna get people killed.
By you.
So Yeah, I killed the widow's husband and the ginger. But I didn't get them killed. That was your boy, Rick.
And Daryl.
Big difference. Yeah, I saw you stop for that Gregory idiot. You were there. You saw the whole thing. You heard his little speech. Why would you stop for that bearded prick?
What I fear is a fruitless death.
Jesus Christ, you gotta be kidding me. He split on your creepy little ass. Point of your life would be saving that dickhead.
That wouldn't be it. There had to be some reason I did what I did.
Creepier than murder. Oh, he's gonna talk about his daughter. Because in the comic book, Lucille is his wife. But in the Comic-Con preview, his daughter is like a Lucille type. She dies of cancer, I'm guessing. And Negan's a big-time sports enthusiast. So maybe they're gonna get into that. Spoiler alert! Oh, that's sweet. Ride with Norman Reedus. Just like a chicken. Superman. Robert Kirkman's Secret History of Comics. Austin Emilio! Dwight! Tom Payne. Jesus.
Did you win? You're the only one? Me. King. The X-Man. And the short-haired psycho lady.
Carol. Jerry.
You did Ezekiel. This?
Ezekiel!
Listen to me, I don't have shit to confess. So maybe the fact that I rub one out right where you're sitting just to calm down a bit. Let me ask you something. Why'd you become a priest?
I love God. And I love people. I wanted to bring them together. To help people through their difficult times. To help them through their weaknesses.
Well, look at that. That's my thing. I like to help people through their weaknesses, too. Been doing it one way or another my whole life.
How do you help
me? You want to know why people are going to start dying in there? Because I'm not there to stop it.
To assume Negan's dead.
I'm Negan. And as I understand it, everyone in this room is. Now, I realize there's a lot of stress in the air. But just to clarify, are you saying you're someone else, Regina?
No.
Good.
We should send the fence crew out. We grab a few others, we get 40 workers standing back to back. We get them out with pipes. They clear a path. Just enough for a small team. What?
The numbers you suggest are inadequate. Given the current SRO density of the herd surrounding us, 40 workers armed with melee weapons, and the formation you propose will be overcome, closed in on, and macked upon within a few minutes.
Yeah, that's right. We use the workers as a distraction to get a small team past the herd. They can warn the outposts and then come back with the fat lady.
Add to the approach's slim chances of success. It's likely the plague would lead to widespread unrest, pitting the workers against the soldiers when we're running out of food and fuel, upsetting our already precarious apple cart.
Maybe. All we need to do is put you out there, Eugene. Maybe it would motivate the answer man to come up with a solution.
Regina, he's right. The workers have the numbers, and we need to keep them on our side.
We need to keep them in line.
Even if we get a few of ours out and somehow clear the crowd, they have snipers all around the building. So right now, let's deal with the other part. Someone in here made everything out there happen. We're having our little crisis management meeting about the rebellion in Alexandria. Us three outpost heads. And that's when they pile this crap on us? That's when they cut us off? Come on. They knows all and sees all. Sometimes it doesn't take a gun. The right kind of rat can kill plenty of people just some talk.
But it's not gonna be us. And it doesn't have to be the workers.
Dwight, you gotta face reality here.
No, Simon, we keep what's ours and we don't give up a damn thing. We get out. And I don't wanna hear backbiting or pissing or moaning from you two.
You got a problem with that, come at me. You can't leave the saviors out of here, I will.
Yes, and...
slowly in front of everyone here.
It's Dwight.
In the course of a few very long days.
Well, it's Dwight, so don't look at Eugene. Regina and Arat are very cute. I like women built like that.
Good meeting people. Now let's make today the best today can be.
Justice League was cool. It was fun. They made Aquaman cool. I was like, what the fuck is Aquaman gonna do when there's no water around? He can glide. Like, he can move his body through the sky when he's falling, you know? Like, he can swim through the air, kind of. He can't fly. If he's falling down, he's going down. But, like, he got airborne. Because he jumped high and he started stabbing parademons. And then when he fell down, he was just glad. I'm like, yeah. And the cyborg caught him and said, I got you. Fight's not over yet. And he was like, my man. And then he threw him. And then Aquaman, like, with the trident, stabbed motherfuckers and shit. And then they fought Steppenwolf and yada, yada, yada. It was cool. It's fun. Fun film. Hold on, there's a knock at the door. Who can that be? Why can't the cops let my party be?
Eight to five. Oh.
Express my sincere thanks for your support of the recent confab. I was doing my level best to stay fully on the DL, but sometimes the mouth-brain neuronal connection experiences a misfire and foot bed mouth at an unavoidable velocity.
You're right in there. If you didn't say it, I would have.
As a token of my appreciation, I brought you some primo cukes from my private stash. I'd like you to accept these as a sign of my faith that we will in fact find a way out of this pickle. Pun intended.
Thanks for stopping by.
Hold up, it's still wet.
My apologies. You DIY'd these?
That's right.
He's still wearing Daryl's vest.
I fully understand the reasoning behind yours truly being prime suspect in pretty much any Benedict Arnold type situation. And in light of that, I'm doubly grateful to have you watching my six.
You're right back there. I didn't say anything more than that. For this?
Kids. You don't show them the way.
Well,
they turn out like garbage. Little assholes become great big ones. So you show them the way. Adults, they need it too. Government, laws, religion, guilt. People are weak.
Everyone?
Everyone.
You're weak. Killing innocent?
Right and goddamn wrong. I'm weak, but me killing the innocent? That ain't why I gave you.
How the fuck a Walker punch?
Wait a little bit longer. See if my people can pull it together.
Why are you weak?
Use your question. Use your machete.
How I am weak. See, the thing is, I am also strong. Everyone is a mix. You can use your weaknesses to drive your strength. And obviously, I am strong as shit. I took this place. It was a damn free-for-all. This confederation of assholes, an army made up of gangs of animals, and I brought it all together. The last guy that was in charge, he wasn't in charge of shit. He allowed people to be weak. I make them strong, which makes this world strong. You're gonna see, Gaby. See, I'm gonna make you my new special project. Gonna make you nice and strong too. Gonna find your special purpose. Hell yes, we are.
I'm strong. I've killed. I was at the satellite station. I was a part of that.
You killed my people while they were sleeping. Well, look at you. Swinging your dick. Sure, Gabe. That's strong. But that's not what I'm talking about.
Tell me how you're weak. You might be dead soon. You may be dead. Would you want to confess before all that happens? Wouldn't you want absolution before that? Forgiveness. Costs you nothing more than saying the truth aloud. You don't think you have anything to confess? The people you've killed?
I haven't killed anyone that didn't need it.
The workers you treat like slaves.
It's an economy. Some people win, some people lose, but no one's a slave, no one's going hungry, and you couldn't say that before all this.
Carl told us about your wives, the women you pressure into marrying you.
Every one of those ladies made a choice.
Was there a first?
Ooh, don't do that.
One before all of this?
Chill out, Gabe.
A wife you promised to have and to hold, forsaking all others. One you told that lie to?
Save me, give me strength.
Oh! Goddamn, Gabe. Masterpiece filmmaking. It's not all blood and gore and people getting shot. It's dialogue, character development, conversation, you know. I like this shit. Who directed this shit? I'm not gonna rewind it. I'm just gonna keep pushing forward. Always forward. Kevin, Brian, Walt, Ming, Mike. Mike's all gray now. Let's do it. Daryl's still fucking with that damn Humvee.
Well,
Give me a hand with this.
We can use these now.
What?
Think about it. There ain't no kingdom no more.
Yeah.
We know what we gotta do. We blow open the sanctuary, let the walkers flood in, they'll surrender. It'll be done. Hell, we need to end this by sundown.
They have workers in there, right? Families, too.
Babies, maybe.
Are there?
Grace.
Well, at the south side of the main building. The workers live in the north side. They'll be up the stairs before the walkers even get in.
What if they don't? There are people in there who aren't fighters. Doing this could change that. Make them pick up guns and stand by the saviors. And if the saviors don't surrender, maybe everyone fights us. And we don't have the kingdom anymore. We're not doing this.
TV in the apocalypse? That's tight. Oh, generator's dead. Still the end of the world. About to get high as shit in that motherfucker now.
Hell.
Darren versus Rick. Throwing explosives, bro. Get on and throw explosives.
Oh no, it's on fire now. Oh, Nero, you idiot. Dumbass.
I mean, Rick. Dumbass Rick. They have valuable explosives, and Rick gonna throw them away. Rick, you fucking dummy. You dumb sack of shit. You ignorant, bearded fuckwad. You stupid, caveman-looking hillbilly. Lunatic motherfucker. Look at Daryl looking at him. Dumbass. Just an idiot. Just a fucking nincompoop. Just a not very bright person. What the fuck? Rick dumbass wanna throw bombs and shit. Fuck wrong with this nigga, man. I tell you, man, some motherfuckers just, their mind ain't right, dog. For real. Niggas' mind's just not right. Craziest shit be happening. Too stupid. Too stupid. Too stupid. Too stupid. Three billboards in Emser. I gotta see that. Damn. See that shit on Tuesday, probably.
is a plan. You gotta see it through.
You got one?
Yeah, we gotta. Chokehold's illegal, asshole.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
Looks like I'm walking.
Yep.
Damn.
At least when I'm done with the last play.
Yep.
You sure about doing it?
Yeah, I am.
Lucille to help us get to the sanctuary. We have that gun. We should use it. Most importantly, Gabriel, we have each other. People are a resource. We make it inside. We live.
Yep, you can do that. Unless Gabriel already left.
Or I can just kill you. But that is not what I want. What I want is for you to work with me. That's all I ever want.
What, a 3D movie playing on E Street? The fuck?
I've killed before, but that's not my gravest sin. Locked my congregation out of my church when the soldiers started. I listened to them die. As I cowered. I failed them. I failed God. Every day, I work to lessen that failure. To be of service, of purpose. Now I offer you the assurance of a pardon, penance, and absolution. I will go with you. I will show you that working together as equals is the only true way to grace. To a future. I will do this. If you confess.
Jesus, Gabe.
Confession time, baby.
What you did, that is some horrible, cowardly, spineless shit. I guess that's what a confession's supposed to be, right? My first wife was a real wife. My only real wife. Till death did us part. It was before this. I lied to her. I screwed around on her. She was sick.
So not his daughter, okay.
And when she went...
Apart from the possession.
When she went, it was during this. Couldn't put her down. That is how I was weak. That is what I will confess. Because, yeah, maybe we do bite the big one here. Dead blood, piss, and shit that have been cooking all day in the Virginian sun. How many people ever gotten sick from this?
We're from Georgia.
Look at you, lucky shit.
We're from Georgia.
The Walking Dead is brought to you by
someone who isn't paying me. Hey, the Red Machete. We back.
The Walking Dead Red Machete is brought to you by Taco Bell.
Chop your arm off, man. Damn, he died too. Could've cut his arm off.
For more, go to AMC.com.
Nope. I hope none of the motherfuckers from The Walking Dead got any sexual harassment charges. Shit. Don't cancel this motherfucker. Fuck House of Cards. Don't cancel this shit. It's my shit. Please behave yourselves, you motherfuckers. For the sake of the people, too, the victims, not just the show. Stand still.
Turned around seeing the state of things, but nothing's come up any of the roads.
You're fucked.
Chem outpost doesn't miss deliveries. Something happened.
Carol.
That Rick guy happened. Our outposts are getting hit.
Ooh.
What is it?
They're coming up the stairs.
Walkers.
The workers.
When did you register? I like it.
They said we'd have to shoot them.
Good actress.
Workers are designated to stay on the ground level.
Nah.
Jesus Christ. It's
specifically their activity, is constrained to the factory floor and the outdoor gardens.
It's too hot down there. And we sure as hell ain't going outside.
Hey, man.
We gonna fix the power.
It doesn't need fixing.
Why again?
We're conserving fuel. Hmm? It's a shared sacrifice.
From Logan Lucky.
Oh, we're sharing now.
Oh,
Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
That sort of tone is not gonna work.
Hey, everyone, everyone! Look, we're gonna get through this. Okay, we just need some more time.
We need some more water. There are young people, old people.
We're rationing that out, too.
We work. You protect us. That was the deal. That's how it was supposed to work.
We need water.
You have a plan for getting us out?
You heard the man. You all need to get back to the factory floor.
Where's Negan?
We are Negan.
Is he dead?
Answer the question.
Everyone has to return to the factory floor now!
I'm not going anywhere.
I need to correct you on that point.
Where's Negan?
Dad!
Oh, shit. Damn.
I am Negan. Anyone else want a bullet?
Jesus.
Anyone?
Negan's back. Hey.
It's not him.
It is him. It is you.
Regina. Now, why'd you have to go and do that?
Oh, she killed a person.
I am guessing that a lot of you fine folks thought I was dead. Chewed up, never to be crapped out again. Here's a little refresher on who the hell I am. I wear a leather jacket, I have Lucille, and my nutsack is made of steel. I am not dying until I am damn good and ready. Now, if y'all excuse me, I am in deep need of a sandwich, a shower, and some of that wilting lion orchid deep tissue shit that Frankie learned in San Francisco. Hell, I might do it all at once. Well, after that, we have some serious business to attend to. Like talking to my right-hand man.
Simon.
You see, we gotta figure out how all this could happen like it happened. And then we're gonna get back doing what we have always done.
Running things.
We will save people.
Savers.
Thank you, Negan. Thank God for you.
And that is why I am here. Gentlemen, gently take him to number two. Gently.
Nuts are made of steel. I wear the leather jacket. I have Lucille, and my nuts are made of steel. Hey, Deuces. Hold on, I gotta give Deuces props. Anything Deuces do, it's like, this is the best Talking Dead ever. Deuces, can't wait. I might film myself watching that too.
Who knows?
Viceland's Jesus and Marrow, Jesus Nice himself, actress and star of Girlfriend's Guide to Divorce, Lisa Edelstein, and Simon himself, Steve Ogden's here. We want to hear from you. Tweet us, give us a call. Talking Dead's coming up next. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Yo. This is a great episode. I wear the jacket. I have Lucille, and my nuts are made of steel.
news is, I figured out where that asshole's gun came from.
And the bad news? They're ours. Stolen from the armory.
Mm-hmm.
A worker couldn't have gotten this many guns without us knowing about it.
They couldn't have got one.
No. One of our own did this, is doing this, right now.
Tell me how we find him, Simon.
We find when the munitions went missing. Through that, we get an idea of how, which hopefully leads us right to who. We start when.
He knows Dwight because of the red paint from the checkerboard. The paint. He knows Dwight. Look at Eugene. Looking like Bill Hicks. A helicopter. Is that Wade? Who the fuck that helicopter? Who the fuck that helicopter? Is that a mirage?
Yo, Dr. Smarty Pants. Here. You solve this thing with the bad smelling convention outside, I will make you very, very happy. But even if you try your best, and I know you try your best, but you don't figure something out, I assure you, I will kill you quickly so you don't have to see all the awful, horrific things that are gonna go down here when we run out of food and water. What I'm saying is that I got your back. Either way, you got mine.
Is that a wolf? That's a wolf watching Rick walk. It's a wolf. Those trash people. Those trash people. Stones on the knuckles.
Eugene Porter. Dr. Eugene Porter here. We were neighbors, traveling companions. We've eaten dog together, so I imagine that joins us in some manner for life. I'm here to formally welcome you to the sanctuary. In our current state of siege, the prickly heat alone might be enough to turn you off the place, so
he's a nigga, is he?
I took it upon myself to bring you some welcome wagon items in hopes of providing some relief. Gabriel.
Did he escape? Did Gabriel escape? He gonna break out that motherfucker. Watch. Oh, he's sick. He got bit. Did he get bit? Diabetic.
See Dr. Carson 2.0 ASAP.
That's why I'm here. It's the reason I'm here. Carson. It's Maggie's doctor. I have to get him out of here.
Yo, Eugene, diabetic. Motherfucker. Well, that was a good episode. And it was entitled
The Big Scary U.
Ooh, back to Jadis next week. I like Jadis. Pollyanna McIntosh. This was The Big Scary U. Auf Wiedersehen.